Now we are going to discuss about the types of the polynomial according to the degree. So if the degree of the polynomial is 0, the degree of the polynomial 0, it is known as the 0 polynomial. Examples here, example 5. Example 5 means it is nothing but it is a x to the power of 0. X to the power of 0 means the power of the x is 0. So 5 is known as the 0 polynomial. And 7 is also 0 polynomial. And 12, minus 15, etc. Now degree of the polynomial is 1, then the name of the polynomial is linear polynomial. Examples 2x plus 5, 4x plus 7. The highest power of the x is 1, so it is the degree of this polynomial is 1, so it is known as the linear polynomial. The degree highest power of the x is 1, so it is known as the linear polynomial. So if the degree of the polynomial is 2, then the polynomial's name is quadratic polynomial. Examples are 5x plus 7 and 7x square plus 12x plus 15. The highest power of this polynomial is 2, so the degree of the polynomial is 2. So this is known as the quadratic polynomial. Here also the highest power of the x is 2, so the degree of the polynomial is 2. This is known as the quadratic polynomial. So now we are going here, if it is the degree of the polynomial is 3, the name of the polynomial is cubic polynomial. So examples are 3x cube plus 2x square plus 5x plus 6. The highest power is 6 means x to the power of 0, x means x to the power of 1, x square means x to the power of 2, x cube means here it is 3. 3 is the highest power of the polynomial. So this is the degree of this polynomial is 3. It is known as the cubic polynomial. And if it is 4, if it is the degree of the polynomial is 4, it is called as then the name of the polynomial is quadratic polynomial. The examples are x to the power of 4 plus 3x square plus 2x plus 5. The highest power of this polynomial is 4. So the degree of the polynomial is 4. So it is known as the biquadratic polynomial. Next, the types of the polynomial according to the number of terms. If the number of terms is 1, if it is 1 term, that is called, the name of the polynomial is monomial. Examples are 3x squared, 4x. The terms are 3x squared one term and 4x is another term. So 3x squared is a monomial, 4x is another monomial. Here 3x squared having only one term, 4x having the only one term. So if the number of terms are 2, if the number of terms is 2, it is called binomial. Examples 3x square plus 2x. In this we have the two terms, that is the first one is 3x square a one term and 2x is also another term. So If it is two, it is having the two terms, then it is called binomial. If it is three terms, it is called if the number of terms is 3, then it is called trinomial. Trinomial. It contains 3 terms. That is 3x squared plus 4x plus 5. It contains 3 terms. 3x squared is one term. 4x is another term. 5 is another term. So here the first term is 3x squared. 4x is another term. 5 is the another term. It is known as the trinomial. It is the polynomial contains 3 terms, then it is known as the trinomial. If it is the polynomial contains one term, it is called monomial. If it is a polynomial contains 2 terms, that is called binomial. If it is a polynomial contains 3 terms, it is known as the trinomial. If it is more than 3 terms, it is called multinomial. Multinomial. So examples here, 4x to the power of 4 plus 5x cube plus 3x plus 3x square plus 2x plus 5. It is a this polynomial contain 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It is containing 5 terms, then it is known as the multinomial. Or we can say we can take 5x cube plus 2x square plus 5x square plus 4x plus 3. So again here it is a remove this one, we will get here 1, 2, 3, 4. It is a polynomial contains 4 terms, then it is also called multinomial. So if it is more than 3 terms, then it is called multinomial. Once again I am repeating this one. If it is a polynomial contains only one term, it is called monomial. If it is contain 2 terms, it is binomial. If it is contain 3 terms, it is called trinomial. If it is more than 3 terms, it is called multinomial. So next exercise 2.1, find the degree of each of the polynomial given below. Here it is given the polynomial. Let P of x is equal to x to the power of 5 minus x to the power of 4 plus 3. So here this polynomial contains 3 terms. The first term is x to the power of 5, second term is x to the power of 4, and the third term is 3. Now we have to find the highest degree of the polynomial. It is known as the degree. So here 3 means x to the power of 0. Here it is the power of the variable is 0. X to the power of 4 means the power of the x is 4. Here x to the power of 5 means the power of the 5. X to the power of the x is 5. So here it is x to the power of 5 is the term x to the power of 5 has the highest degree among the remaining terms in the expression. So the term x to the power of 5 has highest degree among remaining terms in the expression. So here the degree of x to the power of 5 minus x to the power of 4 plus 3 is 5. So next to here it is a x square is the as highest degree among the remaining terms. So 2 is the degree of the polynomial. So here x square the term x square has highest degree among remaining terms in the expression. So therefore the degree of the x square plus x minus 5 is 2. Take for the homework the third one is nothing but 5 is nothing but 5 into x to the power of 0. 0 is the degree of the polynomial. Here what is the highest power of this? 6 is the highest power of the polynomial. The degree of the polynomial is 6. For this one, it is a y square. So the highest power of y is 2. So degree of the polynomial is 2. Here it is t to the power of 1. So degree of this polynomial is 1. So here, now the second problem, which of the following expressions are a polynomial in one variable and which are not? Give the reasons for your answers. So what is the polynomial in one variable? Polynomial in one variable means it contains only one variable. First of all, it is a polynomial. Later we have to check that polynomial is in one variable. So what is the first question? It is given 3x square minus 2x plus 5. So it can, first of all, we have checked, is it a polynomial? So 3, 2, 5 are the real numbers, and it is x square, x and constant. So the powers are positive numbers, it is a non-negative numbers, so it is a polynomial, and also it is containing only one variable, so it is a polynomial in one variable. So here it contains only one variable, so it is polynomial in one variable. So what about the second one? It is a x square plus root 2. First of all, we have to check the is it a polynomial. Here first of all, the coefficients here 1, here it is a root 2. 1 and root 2 are the real numbers, and what is about the second one? The power of the x is 2, so 2 is a non-negative integer, so it is a polynomial, and also it is containing only one variable. The same reason, it is a polynomial in one variable. And what about the third one? Third one is first of all, we have to check that is it a polynomial. Here the coefficients are 1, 3, 1, so they are the real numbers. And what about the powers? Powers are 2, p power 1, q power 1. The powers are non-negative integers. So it is a polynomial, but it contains the two variables p and q. So it is not a polynomial in one variable. So here it contains two variables. So it is not polynomial in one variable. It is not a polynomial in one variable. So what about the next one? Here it is a y plus 2 by y. It is, we can write it as y plus 2 into y to the power of minus 1. So first of all, we have to check that is it a polynomial. So what are the constant? 1 comma 2. 1 comma 2 are the real numbers. There is no problem. What about the powers? Here y to the power of 1. 1 is a non-negative integer. And what about this y to the power of minus 1? Minus 1 is a negative number. So it is contradict to polynomial. So it is not a polynomial. So it is not a polynomial. So it is not a polynomial in one variable. So here the power of the y to the power of 1. So it contains... It is not a polynomial. Therefore, it is not a polynomial in one variable. Next, here it is, we can write it as x into 5 into x to the power of 1 by 2 plus x into root 5. So what are the constant? 5 and root 5. 5 and root 5 are the real numbers. There is no problem. What about the powers of the variable? It is the powers of the variable is 2. 1 by 2 is a fraction. the fractions are not allowed in the polynomial, so it is not a polynomial. It is not polynomial, so therefore it is not polynomial in one variable. The sixth one, the last one, sixth one, it is x to the power of 100 plus y to the power of 100. The coefficients are 1 and 1. 1 comma 1 are the real numbers, and here the powers of the x is 100, the power of y is 100, the powers are non-negative, so they are polynomial, but it contains two variable x and y, so it is not a polynomial in one variable. It is a polynomial, but it is not a polynomial in one variable. So what is the reason? It contains two variables, so therefore it is not a polynomial in one variable.